Hello and welcome to Crazy Danish Hacker. Today we're going to have a look at the PicoCTF. So here I have the latest version of Kali Linux. I've taken the liberty of opening the PicoCTF website and also registered a new user, which you can do by clicking the register button. So let's have a look. See if I can remember my password. If I can, we will just save it, I guess. And I guess we might need Burp Suite as well. So we will just open Burp Suite. And start Burp with the defaults. And just minimize it. So here we have a few things. We have a game, problems, and a shell. So let's see, and also scoreboard. So this will take a while to load by the looks of it. It's made by Unity by the looks of it. And we also have some problems to solve and a shell right here. Let's see if we can log in. And it works. Let's do a full screen. So this looks like it's a real Linux shell, which is pretty cool. You can even press Control L and then you will clear the screen instead of writing clear. So let's have a look at this CTF thing first, I guess.
Hello, I'm going to get straight to the point. I'm Valerie Krenchov and I'm the Director of International Secret Service.
But let's just continue. Let's see. This looks more like a computer game. So I wonder what this is about. Ah, we have to put things on the robot.
Mr. Robot.
No. Let's just have a look at this, what's going on here, to read, because I haven't actually read any of the instructions yet. So let's see, in a text only format. Okay, so it looks like the CTF can also be done just by going through all of these. That's interesting. But you can also do them through this little game. So let's click here. Base 16 in decimal 12. Let's see. 3D. I can't really remember. Let's just open a text editor. Let's see. Is this a text editor? It is. So base 16 basically goes from 0 to 9 and then A to F. While that's base 16. While base 10 goes just from 0 to 9. So that's our regular counting system. So for example, when you reach 10 in base 10, then you get 10. But in base 16, you get an A. All right, so to do this, I would probably just use a calculator. So we can open this calculator here. Now, I actually had to take a look at how it works because I'm only familiar with the Windows version, which is a bit easier to understand unless you're familiar with the Linux version. But in any case, select programming mode, select hexadecimal, and type in 3D. And once you've done that, the answer will be down here. So the answer will be 61, because the 10 down here means that it is base 10, while 75 is in case you're using base 8. So let's submit the answer, 61. And it's not the answer. Ah, okay. We have to submit it in the flag format. And there we go. So that's pretty cool, you know. But let's try and solve it maybe through the problems here. Let's just have a look. Yeah, let's just go through the problems instead here. I think that's easier. So let's see, we have a file. We will just save it to downloads, I guess. And we will open a terminal. Go into the downloads directory. And we could just try unzip, you know, see what it says. And there is a file. So let's open the file. Let's see, what does it say? Ugh. So that's the flag. PicoCTF. Welcome. 2 4 insects. Did we get it right? We did. For some reason I can't open this PNG. Well, let's have a look, shall we? That's odd. So we can see the thumbnail, but we can't see the other thing. Well, not to worry. Let's open our shell again. And in this case, let's just see if we can increase the font size a bit so it's easier to see as well. If it's there, yep. Custom font. 12, maybe 14 size. There. All right. So it's the flag.png. So we will just move the flag.jpg to archive and also the zip file to archive. So we only have the current file that we're working on. So let's see. It says that it's a JPEG file. So I guess if we rename it to JPEG, it will open. And this one says welcome to forensics as well. So I guess we say PicoCTF, welcome to forensics. That is incorrect. For some reason I had the other file opened, so that's why the result was wrong. So we actually already solved it as usual. I will just make sure that this is not running. And for some reason this tab doesn't want to close. So I guess we will just force Firefox to quit. And open it again. And let's see. Well, we're getting a score. And let's see. I can't open this PNG file. So it says extensions are a lie. Ah, okay. PicoCTF extensions are a lie. What would that be in ASCII? That's 40, that's an A. Now, the only reason why I know that is because in when you're writing a buffer overflow, you might want to send a lot of A's to try and crash the service. And then when you look at, for example, the stack, you will see a lot of X41 and then X42, which is B, and then X43, which is C. So, but usually for a buffer overflow to distinguish between the different parts of the overflow, you use different characters, for example, because then one register might be like full of A's and another register will be full of B's, and it will be a lot easier to distinguish where you have to or where you can inject your code. Oh yeah, PicoCTF A. Can you convert the number to base 2? I can. And I think I can even show you how to do it manually. So base 2 is 1 and 0. And it goes like this. 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, and so forth. So what you want to do is that you want to take the highest number. In this case, for example, we have 16. So we say, I can't remember which way it is actually, but anyway, we will just mark this as 1, and then we subtract 16 from the final number. So that's 11. And then we say, can we subtract 8 from 11? Yes, we can. So that's 3. Can we subtract 4 from 3 without getting a minus? No, we can't. Can we subtract 2 and 1 from 3? Yes, we can. So it should be 11011. We can also use the calculator. So in this case, we will say base 10, decimal, 27. And okay, this doesn't show it in binary. So I guess we could just do it like this. 11011. And you can see that will be 27 in base 10. And 1B in base 16, which is hexadecimal. Let's just continue. PicoCTF 11011. And submit. So now we've warmed up and we are ready to hack. So let's see, we put together a bunch of resources to help you out on our website. If you go over there, you might even find a flag. Well, let's have a look then. And there is the flag. So this CTF is for beginners, obviously, and I usually don't do CTFs, but it does say there is some binary exploitation, so maybe we will get to some really cool stuff later on. And also, I'm not really good at crypto or forensics or reversing, but let's have a look anyway. So let's see, throughout your journey, sure. I wonder if you can just copy and paste. So that was the resources page, and let's open the shell. We already have a shell page here. So we connect and login. And let's see, cd paste from browser. File. Okay. Welcome to reversing. Can we copy it? Yes, we can. And let's go to the next one. Can you decode the string? Yes, I can. That's actually very easy. Data text 64. That was simple. So you can also use a lot of tools. You can even use Burp Suite. But yeah, switching between programs, starting up a separate program just for decoding some simple Base64, you don't really have to do that because you can do it in the browser. But be careful if you do it. So let's see, you can also do it like this, you know, decoder tab, code as Base64, and you can also encode it back to Base64 if you want to, if you change it, for example. So this is hello in Base64. So let's go to the next one and click submit.